Windows 11 is out, however, upgrading to it isn't without issues for some. While Microsoft is protecting you by ensuring your system is secured by requiring TPM and Secure Boot to be enabled, actually doing this in BIOS can be slightly tricky and even get you seemingly stuck. And there's other issues that may come up. Every BIOS is a bit different, but in this episode, we'll give you a sample walkthrough and tell you what to look for depending on your motherboard and BIOS. It's possible to get stuck in a loop or two, and you'll need to restart after changing the BIOS at least once, so try not to skip ahead. We'll show you how today. Hey, I'm Rick, your host for today, and we'll give you an overview of how to enable TPM and Secure Boot for your own PC, though every BIOS is slightly different, so please keep this in mind. And don't forget to subscribe to MSI Gaming for the latest news and tutorials. Let's get the caveats out of the way. You should back up your files and data and have program installers, passwords, and product keys saved to another physical drive that isn't C drive, like an external hard drive or USB. And don't forget the folders and files on your desktop, which are easy to miss. Although upgrading to Windows 11 should leave all data and programs intact, we take no responsibility for any loss of data, and you do this at your own risk. The easiest backup is cloning your hard drive. Otherwise, search for How to Backup Your Data tutorials, as Windows loves to store info in the hidden user folder on C drive. And we're working with C drive today. Also, preparing a Windows installation USB drive now is a great idea, especially if you get stuck. Search Create Windows 11 Installation Media, download and run it, and follow the steps. Don't do this on a mission-critical PC without having a backup, and also plan for a day of downtime if you run into problems. Windows 11 at launch still had a few bugs, like File Explorer crashing and some display driver issues, so if you want to wait, that's fine too. If you can, have a laptop nearby to Google any issues or call a tech friend for help. Quickly, Secure Boot is part of UEFI, the newer interface between the BIOS and your OS, and the older was CSM. Secure Boot resists malware, including bootloaders. The Trusted Platform Module are chips which secure hardware with keys. If you bought a PC or enterprise-grade notebook after 2016, it should have TPM 2.0. If it's older, it may have TPM 1.2, or maybe no TPM at all. Okay, all your data is backed up. Our first step is to ensure you have the latest BIOS version for your motherboard. We have a webpage up for support and it lists compatible MSI motherboards, so jump over to that and search for your product model. Follow the steps to download and put the BIOS on a USB drive. And for the update, ensure the USB is inserted into the rear I/O of your motherboard. Now restart your PC and tap the delete key to get into the BIOS, then go through the steps to update your BIOS. You need to know where the CMOS jumper is located on your motherboard. Some manufacturers have an option like Fast Boot, which, if enabled, won't accept keyboard input during startup. Or, if you're further in this guide and have a black screen after trying a step, you can clear the CMOS, which reverts all BIOS settings to default. To do this, turn off the power to the power supply, and very carefully, bridge the CMOS jumper for 10 seconds. Turn the power back on, hit the power button, and tapping delete, you should be able to get into BIOS. Step 2. Whether you use a hard drive, SSD, or NVMe M.2 drive for your Windows install, to use UEFI, your drive needs to be formatted as GPT. The older MBR was used for Windows 7, but recently built PCs will likely already be formatted as GPT. You can find out what format your drive is by right-clicking the Start menu, or press Windows key plus X, and select Disk Management. Alternatively, press Windows key plus R to open the Run dialog, type in diskmanagement.msc, and click OK. The physical disk is on the left, and the dark blue bars show partitions on that disk. Find the disk with your C drive, and on the disk, right-click to bring up a menu, and choose Properties. You'll get a box and click the Volumes tab up at the top. Clicking on it will show the partition style, GPT, or MBR. Note if you click on the partitions, it will give you a different box. And don't do any changes here or you risk wiping data from the drives. With MBR, you have a few options after you've cloned or backed up your data. First, you could try a third-party partition management program to convert MBR to GPT. That may save you reinstalling programs and all your data. However, it is possible to run into partitioning problems. The second option is the utility built into Windows 10, version 17.03 or newer, called mbr2gpt.exe. This is out of our scope, but it can make the conversion without losing or overwriting any of your existing data. Third option, if your drive is MBR, is a clean install of Windows by deleting all data and partitions. And note, you should locate and save your Windows product key and Office or other program keys before you do this. If you're choosing this, make sure you have that Windows installation USB ready, and with power off, open up your PC and disconnect power to any other internal SSDs or hard drives to prevent accidental erasure. Moving on, with the latest BIOS installed, we'll make sure the PC is using UEFI, and this must be done first and the PC restarted before enabling Secure Boot, or you may get stuck in a loop. Tap Delete to get into BIOS, and we'll go to Advanced Mode by pressing F7. In Settings, go to Advanced, then Windows OS Configuration. Check to make sure the BIOS mode is set to UEFI. If it's not, you'll need to change this to UEFI first, then you must hit F10 to save and exit. In other BIOS versions, this may be listed as Windows 10 WHQL support, and older boards may have a Windows 8.1 10 WHQL support entry, or a Windows 7 or 8 toggle, and we'll choose the latest version we can. Some points here. A, if you try to install the Secure Boot keys before doing this, the end dialog is to reset without saving, which will put you in a loop where the BIOS still has CSM selected, and it'll block your enabling of Secure Boot. So save and restart first. B, when you change CSM to UEFI, it's normal for your PC to restart a few times or beep a few times, and it may not post. If you wait 30 seconds without anything happening on screen, just turn off your power supply, wait 10 seconds, turn it back on and hit power and see if it can post. If it's still stuck, you should try clearing the CMOS here. By the way, if you have an MBR drive and are wiping all data with a fresh install, boot into the Windows installer and delete all the partitions on the same drive containing C, so it's one big chunk of space. Then select it and install Windows there. Windows will format it as GPT and install, and again, this wipes all data. Back to the walkthrough. Next, you should test if you can get to the desktop. If yes, great, but if you get a black screen with boot device not found, or Windows doesn't load after a few tries, that means your drive is likely formatted as MBR. See the previous section about how to get it formatted as GPT. Okay, so latest BIOS, drive is GPT, and UEFI enabled. Power on and tap Delete to go to BIOS Settings, Advanced, Windows OS Config. Scroll down to Secure Boot and hit Enter, and we'll install the keys first. Going to Secure Boot Mode, we'll change from Standard to Custom, then the options below will turn active. We'll choose Enroll All Factory Default Keys. The first dialog confirms installing factory default keys, and the second will ask to reset without saving. The keys will be installed, but no other changes in BIOS will be saved. Save and exit, and get back into BIOS. Now we've installed the keys, we can select Secure Boot and choose Enabled. Pressing the Escape key a few times will get us back to the main settings menu, and now we'll select Security, and then Trusted Computing, and then we'll put Security Device Support to Enabled. We won't see an update in status information until we hit F10 to save config and exit, which we'll do now. To see the new status information, tap Delete into BIOS, and going back to Settings, Security, Trusted Computing, you should be able to see the status information listing TPM and version number as being active. We'll boot into Windows, and we can check if TPM is working. Click on Search and type in tpm.msc and hit Enter. The status will say ready for use, and in the middle column, if you scroll right, it will give the specification version. How do we check if Secure Boot is enabled properly in Windows? Just click Search and type MS Info and hit Enter. And halfway down the list, you'll see Secure Boot State, and this should say On. You have the best chance now to run Windows Update and have it be successful. It may take a few times to update and restart. It's still possible it may say your system doesn't meet the minimum system requirements for Windows 11. If it isn't essential to update right now, maybe you can try again later. There's always a drive wipe and fresh Windows install if you're feeling lucky. To wipe all data and fresh install, plug the Windows 11 installation USB into the rear of the motherboard and shut down. If you have other internal SSDs or hard drives with the main power cable removed, disconnect any additional SSDs or hard drives to prevent erasing them. Power cable back in, power on. If the Windows installer doesn't load, restart again and tap delete to get into BIOS and set your USB as the first boot device. Save and exit. Otherwise, proceed to install Windows 11 and this should hopefully work for you. This tutorial took a ton of research and time to test, so hopefully by following it, it eases the pain of making the leap. If this guide helped you or you learned something, be sure to hit that thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to MSI Gaming for the latest news. Thanks for joining us today and happy gaming. See you all next time.